Vaccines save more than 9 million lives each year, even though they contain ingredients that can be pretty dangerous. But that's precisely the point. Those nasty ingredients are the only reason that vaccines work at all. On their own, our bodies are already pretty good at fighting off illness. When an unfamiliar pathogen invades our body, patrolling immune cells engulf a few of these foes to gather intel. The cells then churn out a chemical alarm, transmitting the enemy's information along the chains of command and triggering the production of specially targeted antibodies and assassin cells to fend off the rest of the invaders. After the battle, some of these specialized troops stick around so that if the pathogen returns, they can help mount a quicker response. However, some pathogens are so powerful that they can overwhelm the immune system before it's able to mount a defense. Vaccination lets us stage a practice version of this battle in advance of the real one, so that the immune system can develop and stockpile weapons specifically targeted at the enemy. That does require introducing a bit of the enemy into our bodies, but it's an enemy that we've already disarmed, either by killing it, breeding a super weak strain, or dismembering it to get at recognizable, but not dangerous, parts. Enter formaldehyde. It's a critical ingredient in some common vaccines, like those for tetanus and influenza, because it alters the structure of those pathogens just enough to render them harmless. This reactivity also makes formaldehyde dangerous to us in large doses, but vaccines contain only a tiny fraction of the formaldehyde we consume in food and naturally produce in our bodies on a daily basis. In fact, the biggest risk with formaldehyde is that it can leave pathogens so crippled that they won't trigger the proper immune response. So some vaccines contain substances called adjuvants, which put the immune system on higher alert. Aluminum, for example, causes a minor irritation at the injection site, summoning immune cells to the scene so they'll encounter the weakened enemy. And although too much aluminum can be toxic, our bodies are super efficient at eliminating it, keeping levels low even after lots of shots. So while boatloads of aluminum, buckets of formaldehyde, and an up-close meet-and-greet with a full-strength pathogen are all definitely bad ideas, a controlled concoction from a doctor is designed to be just nasty enough to keep us safe. There's always a chance of an adverse reaction to a vaccine's ingredients, but the much scarier scenario would be to let polio, measles, and other deadly diseases call the shots. A big thank you to Lisa.com for sponsoring this Minute Earth video. Lisa.com is an online mattress company that offers luxury three-layer foam mattresses without the big price tag. Your new mattress will be shipped right to your door, and you'll have 100 nights to try it out. If you don't love it, you can return it for a full refund. And we at Minute Earth love that Lisa donates one mattress to a homeless shelter for every 10 they sell. Lisa is offering Minute Earth viewers $75 off a new mattress. For your discount, go to lisa.com/earth and use offer code Earth75 so they know we sent you. Thanks, Lisa!